Hey, what's up? This is Shawn from Leletone, and today I'm going to record this cardboard harp, cut it up into Kontakt, Ableton, and OP-1 patches so that you can use it in your own tracks at home. Let's check it out! Alright, first things first, let's take a look at this. So basically, it's just a really simple version of a harp. You have 19 nylon strings, and 19 tuning pegs, you know? And then these three pieces of wood that hold it are connected to this piece of cardboard in the back. And this acts as like a resonator, sort of like if you have the hollow body of an acoustic guitar, all the strings, the sound of the strings goes in there and then it gets amplified, right? This does the same thing. I don't know a whole lot about this because actually it was a Christmas present from Yoshimi maybe 15 years ago, maybe even more than 15 years ago. But I looked up, that company is called Waring. What is it? Waring. It's called the Waring Harp Kit. Isn't that the cheapest thing in the world, you know? But like, if you just want to like sit around your house, like feeling like you're floating on clouds or something, this might be exactly what you need, you know? But I'm being super honest, I probably haven't used this nearly as much as a lot of our other instruments. I like it a lot. It's just sometimes it's hard to find a place for it to fit in. I think it would be good like if you're making like some dream sequences in a film or oh man, you know what would be really good? If you're making like a fake Muji soundtrack, like whenever you go shopping in Muji, they play all the like, Celtic music. I don't know how to do Celtic music, but you could probably use this to do that, right? One of the reasons it's not on a lot of our records, I think, is because it's pretty hard to record and make it sound good. But to make this sample set, I think I came up with a pretty good idea for how to get it. Let me show you. All right, if you're a harpist or you really love harps, I'm sorry about this one. It's probably like sacrilege or something. But check this out. What if we put it on this table sideways? What's gonna be good about that is it gives us easy access to, once again, the back. Check this out. So now, from back here, I think I'm gonna go stick the microphone in this way, and then another one right over the strings. So I have this one condenser microphone that's pretty skinny. I'm just gonna insert it back here into the sound hole so you get this kind of like round, deeper tones. And then I have another one over here that I'm gonna use on top of the strings. So we'll get the kind of pluck on the top from the strings, and then we'll also get the kind of like resonating like hollow part. This is both mics mixed together, and then let's try just this top one. And then just the inside mic. And then both of them together again. So I came back in the nighttime, when there's not a soccer practice in the field in front of here and like 1,000 cars driving by, and recorded it when it's a little bit quieter. But still, it's a really quiet instrument, right? So there's a lot of noise coming up. And I don't mind it like in my own tracks, but I don't know if everybody wants it. So I found a pretty good way, I think, like a cheat around it. I put it in the computer and I denoised it. Like there's a way you sample the noise, like the room tone, and then take it out. I did that and it made all the decays feel really short. So instead of being like, it'd be like, not that short, but felt like they all died. So I added in a little bit of reverb on the denoised version. When you get these like really nice, long sustaining notes, it was pretty good. So I'm gonna include both of those versions in there. There's like the original, I'll call it the natural version. And then I'll just call it cardboard harp, the one that's denoised. Alright, so now we have the clean version and the natural version. And they're both good, you know? But one of the things I want to do with this project of making sample sets is to try to make some stuff that feels like a little bit more special, like things that you wouldn't get right out of the box if you just bought Kontakt or Ableton or something like that. I guess one of the easiest ways to do it would be to dirty it up, you know? Like, a lot of the times whenever you get samples, one of the things like people will go for is trying to make it as clean as possible. But on the flip side, if you make it dirty, it has a little bit of texture and character. So the easiest go-to idea for that, and this is what I thought of at first, was to run it through this old cassette tape player. And I tried it, and it kind of just didn't sound that special. Like, we have one sample set already called Cassette Clarinet, where I recorded a bunch of clarinet sounds of this, and that sounded great. It sounded like an old Mellotron. But this has so much character, it just made it made the harp pretty much sound the same as the clarinet. So then my next idea was to use this other tape player. I use this one a lot for like full tracks or like bouncing something big. But this was like the opposite. It's so good that it was kind of like pointless. It didn't sound that different. It was like pretty much like you're just playing it again, you know? It sounded like this, but with slightly less high end. So I thought about a way of like faking it. This is the SP404SX. It's a sampler, but one of the things that's really good about it is that it has all these built-in effects. You can't see anything on here. But number 16 is called, what is it? Vinyl simulation. And this one's really nice. If you run stuff through there, it has like this kind of like old lo-fi effect. I also wanted to use this pedal called Warp Vinyl. So it's like vinyl 1 going into vinyl 2. And the thing that these do is they add a little bit of like wow and flutter to the sound. Like it puts an LFO that makes the pitch go in and out a little bit. So I thought it'd be kind of cool to have like this pitch set on like one tempo and this one on another. So that they're like really crisscrossing and fading around. Okay, let me show you how I set it up. So we have this MIDI keyboard right here, just controlling the samples. And then I took that and used Ableton to send it to an external out. So not going to like these normal speakers, it's gonna go to an out. And in the back of the audio interface here, you have a bunch of different outs. So I put one of those going out into this guy, coming in here. And then I wanted to connect it to this pedal too, and like pedals need these kind of patch cables or guitar cables. So I came out of the headphone, boom, into the input here, out of here, follow it back into input two on there. And then, whenever you play this, you'll get that kind of oof, nostalgia. So on the SP404, you can control the flutter. That's the amount of like the pitch going in and out. This is with none of it. What's going on here, though? You can add like a filter, so roll off the high end a little bit, add in a little bit of noise. I'm gonna be super honest, I don't love the noise on here that much. So I made my own sample. I recorded the tape hiss from this, put it into here, and then I can play this one. It has less crackles and pops, so it sounds less like a vinyl and more like a cassette tape, which I kind of like. It kind of sounds less like rain and fire and stuff too. So, then you have this one. Re-record it all into here, and then you can resample it, like recut it up. So to make it easy, I just made a MIDI file that has all the notes I'll need. And then you can record it. One of the things that's really cool about cutting up the sounds and putting it in the computer is that other than just like being able to share it with other people, you can add lots of effects. So this is straight up, right? But then here in Ableton, I added, let's see, what did I put on here? Just really simple ones. I put a filter, a chorus, and then an echo. And then when you do that, it changes the way that you interact with the sounds a lot, I think. So on this version, it starts to sound like... That changes the way you play it, you know? I also have it working in the OP-1. Which is cool because then you can arpeggiate it, like... Alright, so that's it for this month's sample pack. I hope you like it, I hope you can use it, I hope you make awesome songs, all that kind of stuff. If you do make something cool, send it to me, I'd love to check it out. And thanks for checking this out. Alright, I'll put a couple more tracks of like just using the sounds, you know, so you can get another idea of what it sounds like. Also to fill out and make it longer so I get that sweet, sweet AdSense from YouTube, you know? Alright, later!